you, you know, we're kind of there. We want to do like hard contact, but like plus counts.
Okay. So what's a plus count to you?
Like where I got less strikes, more balls, so like 1-0, 2-0, 3-0, maybe 3-1.
Yeah, absolutely. So one you didn't mention, I'm just going to pull up the stats here from Division One baseball last year. So I'm just going to ask you a quiz here. D1 baseball, best hitters, best pitchers, right? All count. What do you think the batting average was last year?
All?
Yeah, all.
Probably like 360.
On the dot.
Really?
Yeah, 359. All right, so just kind of reemphasizes the importance of, right, when you step in the box, you got to be mentally locked in, okay? That's going to allow us to, you know, put our best swing forward, okay? So what's going to happen today, as you work on this, you kind of want to plant some seeds in the tree to go, right? We want to build that good foundation for our swing, all right? So just to start, just get your stance real quick. So you want to have your back foot there pretty comfortable?
Yeah.
Right there?
Yeah.
All right, good. Now let me just see you low the stride real quick. Low the stride. Alright, so I just want you to hit the ball real quick.
Just hit one.
Yeah, you feel pretty comfortable to you?
Yeah. Yeah, I felt like I was like a little bit like out front though. Really got that
ball. Okay, cool. So, let's hit one more. I want you to feel comfortable with that stride length to start.
Full swing?
Yeah, full swing. A little bit better?
Yeah.
Alright, cool. Alright, so for every set, try and have that load or that starting spot and that load stride be exactly the same, okay? We can both agree on that, you know, in order to put your best swing on it, right? That's gotta be consistent every time, right? Okay. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go four swings, okay? And after each kind of set of four, let's just kind of think about or talk to each other about how we're feeling on it, alright? Just do four swings right in a row.
Consistency of like where I'm planting my back foot.
Got it.
And like just like a decent stride, nice extension.
Yeah, I thought so too. But I think we can be a little bit better with our stride, right? A couple strides, your toes on that white line, a couple times it was bad, a couple times it was short, right? Wasn't consistent every time. Alright? So in order to do that, I'm just gonna put
right there.
Okay. Right at that T. Same spot every time. While we do this, I want you to just still focus on having that back foot the same and our stride length the same, right? Because that's going to give us our best chance to do it. Okay? These next four, let's see how many out of four, all right, we hit hard, we think our base hits, that'll get that run, all right?
thought that was a little bit quick. Okay. So when you step in the game, you have a little pre-pitch routine. I know when I play,
right, but before the corners, I put my foot up and I'm ready to go.
You have one, you do?
Yeah,
every single time.
I noticed you did it in the first round, but you didn't do it on the last three.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right? So in order to kind of have that repeatability, okay, keep it going and get in that game situation, I think it'd be a good thing just to get in that habit of doing your pre-pitch routine every time, right? So we're kind of getting locked in, we have a little bit of time in between the reps, and refocus our energy, right? Doing a pre-pitch routine, I'm ready to go, and that we want to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right, we'll try it for the last 4 reps.
Same situation.
Same situation. Guy on second, 2 outs, end of the game. Stepping up from the box, you can see that. Back to if we can actually get in that situation. Oh man, it is just a coach skip, right? I'm ready to go.